What's poppin', all stars? Welcome back to my channel. It's Damn She Jamaican, your biggest and brightest shining star. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about Saturn in Taurus / Saturn in the second house. After I broke down Saturn in what Saturn represents in the birth chart, if you only have Saturn in the second house, I will post a timestamp so you can fast forward and see what that means if you're only here to see that part of the video. All right, so Saturn in the birth chart represents boundaries, restrictions, limitations, hard work, discipline, our career aspirations, our goals, ambition, and how we work hard to get what we want. It also is the father of time and it represents karma. So just for contrast, Jupiter in the birth chart represents expansion and Saturn represents contraction. So this energy, if you have Saturn, wherever you have Saturn or whatever sign you have Saturn, it's going to make it feel very hard, and it's going to make it seem like it's very hard for you to really hone in on these qualities and this area of life. So if you have Saturn in Taurus, I personally think this is a very good materialistic placement. Saturn in Taurus is very good at accumulating wealth. It's good at accumulating material things. Saturn in Taurus has a real problem when it comes to hoarding and collecting physical things. I noticed that Saturn in Taurus is a type of person that's very hardworking, and they're also very reliable people. A lot of people can depend on a Saturn in Taurus. Saturn in Taurus people can be crutches for other people, meaning a lot of people could depend on you, and that may or may not be a good thing depending on who it is. So you have to understand when you have Saturn in Taurus, just to understand why people around you and what it is that they're getting from being around you. With this placement, you could be very controlling. You could really like to, because it's a physical fixed earth sign, you may be the type of person that really loves possessions. You know, when it comes to your family, you're the type of person that really, really wants to know and take care of people and provide and just be that stable rock for people to depend on. Also, having this placement, because you are so stable and because you're so fixated and you love to work hard and accumulate things, it could be very hard for you to ask for help when you need it because you feel like you're the type of person that has it all together. So you don't necessarily want to ask other people to help you with other things. So with this placement, I would definitely say that it's very good for you to learn how to do things in moderation and learn how to have a healthy relationship with materialistic things. And also, Saturn in Taurus is a very ambitious sign. It's an ambitious placement. A lot of people, like I said, they look up to you and they see you as very stable. If you're noticing that you have a problem with collecting things and being super stable, it may be easy for you to help to balance out this energy if you give some of your things away, or if you just lighten your load a little bit. Having Saturn in Taurus, this could seem like a very heavy, heavy energy, heavy placement, because you're the type of person that has a lot of earthly energy going on, and you could be weighed down sometimes by the things that you possess. Overall, having Saturn in Taurus, you are a very loving person, and you definitely do care about how you show up into the world and what it is that you have to offer. And this is why materialistic things are very important to you, because if you feel like you can't like have certain materialistic things, it's very hard for you to accomplish, you know, a lot of things we need, because we are living in a materialistic world. But it's very important for Saturn in Taurus to understand that we are gearing towards living on earth in a more airy way. So being able to communicate more, being able to be more creative, and not so much working hard and slaving ourselves away for us to achieve what it is that we want to achieve in life. So my advice, if you have Saturn in Taurus, is to learn how to breathe, learn how to lighten your load, And, you know, Saturn is about restrictions and limitations. So sometimes, you know, and vice versa, you could be the type of person that doesn't have a lot of, you know, materialistic wealth, and you don't have a lot of things. You don't have a lot of physical possessions. So this may be something that you overly emphasize on working on receiving and getting. So you may work very, very hard because you feel like you lack these things. You feel like you lack material wealth. Even if to another person you may seem like you have it all, to you personally, having Saturn in Taurus, because Saturn is a restricting energy, it's about responsibility, you will always feel like you need to accomplish and you need to acquire physical things. So like I said, my advice would just be to understand how to take things in moderation and learn that materialistic things aren't necessarily the most important things in the world. Yes, we do live in the 3D dimension on Earth, and physical possessions are very important, but we shouldn't let it overrule who we are and how we show up in our lives, okay? So if you have Saturn in the second house, this means that you are the type of person that you need to learn how to value who you are, and it may be hard for you to value certain talents that you have, certain gifts that you have, and it may be something. Saturn in the second house also could be a placement where you really want to acquire a lot of the physical and earthly possessions of the second house. So you may work very hard and you may attribute a lot of your self-worth, because the second house is about our values, and it also derives, and it's also a house that we derive our self-esteem from. So if you have Saturn in the second house, you're the type of person that you want a lot of possessions, and a lot of these physical material possessions is kind of what you use to validate yourself, you know. So you may be a very hard worker. No, not maybe, you are a very hard worker, and it's very important for you personally to accomplish a lot of gain, wealth, you know, money, these material things that help us move forward in life and gain a sense of stability is very important if you have Saturn in the second house. Saturn in the second house is also, you know, like I said, Saturn is restricting. It deals with time and it's karma. So having Saturn in the second house, a lot of your karma is going to come from your personal values. So a lot of the things that you love in life, you're going to have to redefine what it is that you need to work on in order to gain a sense of confidence in your life and self-esteem. So, you know, this placement may look like if you're homeless, if you don't have a house, if you don't have a car, if you don't have food, shelter, you know, if you don't have these physical material things, you may feel less than, or you may feel like you're not living up to your full potential. And Saturn, like I said, it represents limitations and restrictions. And by the time Saturn hits its return around the age of 28 to 30, you'll start to gain more structure and stability in the second house. But for the most part, you're gonna go through challenges, especially in this era of, you know, the Saturn and Aquarius era. It's very challenging for Saturn and Taurus because throughout the pandemic and stuff, a lot of your material things, a lot of your possessions and things that you value have been put to the challenge. So you may have to redefine what it is that you find, where you find your self-worth at, you know, what you find your self-worth in. So you may be the type of person that goes through sudden loss and gains of material possessions. But these things over time is just to teach you that, you know, Saturn wants you to understand who you are and what you value, and know that these outside material things don't necessarily mean this is what you're worth. So just because you have a car, a house, or because you don't have a car and a house, that doesn't mean that you're not valuable and that you're not, it may seem like that, but that's not necessarily what it means. So having Saturn in Taurus, having Saturn in the second house is a very challenging place. It could be challenging, especially when you don't feel like you have the material things that you need. But it's important to understand that you are all you need. And on this physical world, us, our vessel, this physical 3D body, is very important for us to take care of. So Saturn in the second house, it's very important for you to take care of your, you know, physical body. Eat healthy. And overall, this will help your confidence. It will help your self-worth and your self-esteem. All right, because Saturn in the second house pretty much the second house rules our self-worth, all right? So that's pretty much it. Saturn, like I said, Saturn rules karma. And so throughout time, it takes time for people to get to understand Saturn, and it takes trial and error. It takes multiple times of failing. So with this placement, you may really want to accomplish a lot of material physical possessions, but you may go through troubles in life and understanding how you go about doing these things. But this placement is definitely going to call for you to work very hard. You know, but it also, Saturn deals with, you know, duty and dignity and responsibility. So being a hard worker is very important, but don't be so much of a hard worker that you overwork yourself, and that whenever you don't accomplish something that you think you're supposed to accomplish, that you let it affect your self-worth. All right. So just know that you are still powerful, you're still accomplished, and know that if you're continuing to work towards these things. So you may be working towards getting a car or a house, whatever, and you may feel like, dang, I can't get this yet. But just know that Saturn wants you to keep working on it. But don't let, because you don't have something, means that you lack something. Just keep working on it, and throughout time, once you put in that work, that karma will come back to you. And you'll get what it is that you want. But Saturn just really wants you to work hard and accomplish those things. But like I said, don't let the lack of something deteriorate you or, you know, make you feel less than. All right? That's pretty much all I have to say. If you want a birth chart reading, please go ahead and email me. Also, go ahead and subscribe to my Patreon, because I make blogs on there about all your birth chart placements. So if you want to read what I have to say about your birth chart placement, I would love for you to subscribe to my Patreon. Plenty of information over there, and I would love to see you over there, all right? If this is your first time, don't forget to subscribe. Also, like the video and comment down below to let me know what you think of this placement. All right, that's it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in another one. Mwah. Peace.